Hey everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andrew Kröger from Dagubi. Today I would like to show you how to create brushes, how to draw with the brushes, and how to draw a tree with these brushes, and how to apply gradients to the leaves. I start this tutorial with a new document. Go to File and click New. So I use 340 mm for the width and 210 mm. And I use color mode RGB. Click OK. So in this tutorial I'm going to create three different brushes. And I start with this brush. So first choose the polygon tool. And now click on your artboard. And I use 20 mm and three sides. Click OK. So now go to this corner and rotate the shape, hold down the shift key. So next choose direct selection tool and now select first the left two points and now click on this little circles and drag a little bit and now select again the left two points and delete this point because I'd like to change straight line to a slightly curve. So delete these two points, go to the toolbar on top and click on this button, remove selected anchor points. So next select the right point and now again on the top toolbar click on that button, convert selected anchor points to smooth. And now hold the Alt key and drag this handle just a little bit. So that's fine. And now again select the left points and convert these points to smooth. Click again on this button and now hold the shift key and move this handle so that's fine. So next choose the ellipse tool and create an oval like this. So now choose the direct selection tool and select only the left point. And this time I'm going to use the scale tool. And now hold the control key and select the right point and scale this. And now choose again the direct selection tool, select two center points and move these points to the left. Use your arrow on your keyboard. So that's fine. So now zoom in. So next you have to choose the Add Anchor Point tool and I'm going to add two points. So and with the Direct Selection tool select center point and move this point with your keyboard on the left to the left. So now with the scale tool, scale this point, this handles like this. And move these two points. So with the direct selection tool, select some of this one point and move this point down and this point up. So that's fine. My second brush, and now you have to make a copy from that brush. So hold down the Alt key and drag it to the right. You can hold down the Shift key to move it in the horizontal align. So next I'm going to create a new shape with two colors. So that goes like this. Choose the direct selection tool and select the left point and the right point. And now go to the toolbar on top and click on this button, cut path at selected anchor points. So now we have two shapes. So change the color, go to the swatches and change the fill color to gray. And now it's necessary to join these two points. So this shape are open and you have to close it, and you have to use select one of these shapes and now go to Object, Path, and click on Join, and make the same with the second shape. Select Object, Path, or you can use the short key and click on Join. So now we have two shapes. Now I'm going to create brushes from these shapes, and I start with this shape. I recommend you to scale the shape before you create a brush. This is the shape for the branch. So, and when you draw with this brush, this size is one point when you draw with the paintbrush tool. So create a brush, you can click on this button, new brush, or you can go to the brushes panel options, click new brush, or you can drag this brush into the brushes panel and choose art brush. Change the direction from left to right and change the colorization method to tints and click OK. So next brush, it's my first leaf. So select this, and you don't have to scale this because when you create an art brush, I'm going to change the brush scale options to scale proportionately and change the colorization method to tints. Make the same with the second leaf, select both shapes, and now go to the brushes panel, click on this button, new brush, choose art brush, change the brush scale options to scale proportionately and change the method to tints. Okay, I'm done with the brushes. And I'm going to test the brushes, so choose the paintbrush tool. Choose my first brush, change the stroke color to brown. And now the second brush with green color. And the third brush. So now I'm going to create a new layer. So I start with the first brush. If you like to change the basic size of this brush, so I recommend you to make a double click on this brush and you can change afterwards the basic size of the brush. And if you like to draw with different sizes, so in that case you have to change the stroke width into the stroke panel or here on the toolbar on top. So change the color more brown. So that's fine. So next I'm going to move some of these lines and change the stroke width. So if you like to change the stroke width in very small steps, select the line and now go to the stroke width and hold the control key and click on these small arrows. So now I'd like to change some of these points. So choose the direct selection tool and I'd like to change this point to corner. So select this point and go to the toolbar on top and click on this button, convert selected anchor points to corner and make the same with other points. So next, choose a paintbrush tool and I use the second leaf. And it's important to change the stroke width to 1 point. So, and I start with orange color. Dark orange. So during your draw with the paintbrush tool, you can hold down the control key to move leaves. was too big. Hold down the control key and move the leaves. So if you'd like to draw behind the branches, you have to change the drawing mode. So go to the toolbar on the left side and click on this button, hold down the mouse key and choose draw behind. Sorry, again. And now again, go to the left toolbar and change it to draw normal and continue with the leaves. Okay, after you are done with the leaves and you are happy with the tree, I recommend you to make a backup from the whole layer, so drag this layer down to the new layer button and rename it. Make a double click on the group and the layer and rename it to backup. So next, select the whole group, go to object and click on expand appearance. And now I'd like to apply a gradient to the leaves. So that goes like this. Choose the magic wand tool. Deselect all, hold the control key and click on the white artboard. Go to the magic wand tool options and check fill color and set the tolerance to 0. And now click on one of these two colors. So next you have to choose a gradient. So go to the fill color and open the swatch library menu, gradients, and so, and I use green color, green gradient, but it's important to change the fill color, not the stroke color. So change the stroke color again to none. Choose the fill color and again apply a gradient. That's fine. And now with the magic wand tool, click on this orange. So apply the same gradient, and I recommend you to change the color a little bit. So click on the right handle slider and make it a little bit more red. If you like, you can select the other gradient. And you can change the angle. So set this, for example, to 45 degrees. Select the other gradient and change the angle to 30 degrees. So next I'm going to change the color of some of these leaves. So choose the selection tool and select some of these leaves. Hold down the shift key to select multiple leaves. So now you have some options to change the color. You can use the recolor artwork tool. So click on this button. And now click edit. And click on this button, link harmony colors. And drag the slider. Okay. Or select some of these leaves again with the shift key. Now go to edit, edit colors, and this time I use adjust color balance. Enable the preview. So if you are done with the tree, you can draw more leaves and use the same technique. First, you cannot draw with gradient. You have to change the stroke color to solid color. Okay, I'm done. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.